Good morning. Good Friday morning, everybody. So, I'm just doing a quick update on my TEMU makeup from yesterday before I get started with my new TEMU items I'm going to show you. It was great. I have it on again today. The only thing I changed was I used my contour instead of the contour it came with. I probably will still use that contour. I'm not one to just like throw stuff out. So I'll probably still use it, but I think it makes my face look really bright. I feel like my old foundation made my face look, I mean, it's a little tiny bit orange, but like I said, I'm gonna tan up. I tan a lot in the summer, like I'm not purposefully, but just being outside, my skin gets really brown. So this eyebrow here has kind of got a couple goofy spots, but honestly, this is all of the makeup from yesterday again, and I love it. I'm definitely gonna buy more of it and switch. So I just wanted to let you guys know that. By the way, when I by the time I went to bed, it looked exactly the same. So either the setting spray, I need to try it with and without the setting spray, because with the setting spray, I mean, it looked good. When I woke up this morning, I did not wash it off before bed purposely, because I figure I'll start using those products maybe tonight. But it looked good. I woke up looking pretty much almost like this. So that was awesome, because usually, like even the setting spray I replaced the Urban Decay one with, it wasn't as good as this, or was just about as good as this. So anyway, just want to let you guys know that. Give an update on the products from yesterday. So today I'm going to be using that white trim to do the caulking in my shower. I purposely let my shower get disgusting. I mean, it is bad. Because there's a few things I want to do in this video. So this may be a little confusing, but I'm going to do a couple of products in this video. One's Temu. I might actually split it into two videos just because it is kind of weird, I think, to do a Temu and then mix it with another product I'm going to use. But the other product I'm going to use is a product that I have a jetted tub in the bathroom, and when you run the you put it in the water and tub, fill it above the jets, and then you turn the jets on for like I leave it on for like a long time, like 30 minutes. It gets all the gunk out of the jets. So I'll show you that. And then I'm going to scrub the tub down. I'll show you the products I use for that. I'm going to dry the grout area really, really well. And I'm going to use the new trim stuff and show you that and how that works. And I think that's it. So, yep, we're going to get to it. All right, guys. All right, guys. So this is our bathroom. This is our only upstairs bathroom. We have a full bathroom in our basement as well. So I have my blow dryer ready. This is going to be the stuff from Temu that goes on the where caulking would go. Now, it did not make it clear whether you would leave old caulking in or not. I'm going to leave it in just because I feel like it's even that much more of a barrier from water in case this stuff fails. I let this shower get disgusting. I will say this shower gets this way super quick. I think part of it is because it's jetted. Part of it's because we have so many people that take daily showers, you know. But look, that stuff comes right off too. I mean, you literally can just wipe it off. But I wanted it to be a really good before and after. All right, so these are the products I'm going to use. I'm going to use this Mega Shower Foaming Cleaner. It works really well. And my scrub brush. I was watching a video, one of my YouTubers had like a motorized or electric one, and I thought, oh, I think it was on sale too. Last I saw on Amazon for like 20 something dollars. I've got to get one of those. Whoop, Clorox wipes. I may or may not use this bleachy type cleaner depending on if there's any spots I need to get with that. I'll just set that to the side, or may not need it. And this is the stuff I'm going to use with the jets once it's clean. You guys will see how gross that is. All right, let me spray this and I'll let it sit for a bit and scrub it. Actually, I guess I'll show me spraying it at least. All right, well, I hope you guys can see
this, enough of this. I've got this little guy too. I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to dig hair out of drains with this new TEMU thing I showed you yesterday. So that should be interesting. All right. So I'm going to start with this. I don't have a ton of it left. I think I might have a new one in the closet. All right, guys, I'm back. I let it sit for about, hopefully you guys can't see the shampoo bottle I've got you perched on, against rather, so it can lean in and you can see me scrubbing, but it had about 15 minutes to soak. All right, I got my scrub brush. You guys are going to, I guess I'll probably silence this because you guys don't really want to hear this. Turn it over on hot. All right. So guys, I'm losing my mind, I guess. I don't know. I can't find the comment, but that's all right. I'm just going to use some Clorox wipes to get the like body soil out of the, that's such a gross term, out of the tub. So that should work just fine. Hopefully you guys can see me. I'm not even really giving it much elbow grease, and it's just wiping that right off. And then I'll show you the jets, too, after I get a hold of those with the scrubber. Alrighty. So for the star of the show, Oh Yuk Jetted Bathtub Cleaner. I've used this two other times. Use, I think it says a third of a cup at a time. Oh, 4 ounces. So a quarter cup. I just eyeball it. It's a 16-ounce bottle, so I try to just use a quarter at a time. So I'll probably use it down to about there this time. But first, I'm going to fill the tub with hot water. And look how much better it is looking. So much better. This area back here is still kind of stained up. That is the part I would spray with bleach, and I may do that here in just a second. I'm covering that with the new grout. I don't know why my camera's going in and out, in and out with that. So I'm going to fill this with hot water. And I'll come back. Check out the mirror, guys. So the tub's about to the spot it should be. I'm gonna turn this off. It is letting off a lot of humidity and heat. And then I'm gonna add a little more than what it says because I don't know what they're basing it off of tub size wise. So I'm gonna dump in like half of what's left of this. All right, and then I have a switch on my wall. And it says let it go for 15. I think last time I did it, oh, you can already see stuff coming up. Last time I did this, I think I did 30. Look, in just the first few seconds, guys, check it out. So I want you to see this in the first few seconds. Now watch when I come back in 15 to 30 minutes. Okay. All right. The moment of truth. The bathroom is so fogged up with heat that I had to kind of turn the fan on in here. It's very slick. Make sure I don't fall. Guys, look. Is that not disgusting? Oh my gosh. I'm gonna flip off the jets. Get in close so you guys can really get a feel of it. Is that not nasty? Ugh. Okay, so now I gotta figure out how to get the plug out of the drain. Because I am not putting my hand in that. Sorry for all the noise, guys. I got multiple fans going right now because it's so steamy in here. But look as it drains. Ugh. Oh. My gosh.
That is nasty.
Alright, I'm gonna rinse this all up and show you, and then we'll get to work on the caulking strip. Alright, I'm back. So it says I put my hair up, I'm sweating like crazy. It says to heat up the tape with a dryer. So I'm gonna do that. And then I think what I'm gonna do, I was trying to figure out how I'm gonna do it exactly, because it's like beveled, it's not straight corners. I wish it was. So I think what I'm gonna do is just try to do the entire shower in one flail swoop. One fail swoop. Yeah. Here we go. So it's like a sticky tape that you pull off. Okay. And it's got like a seam in the middle. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Okay. I like the concept. It's like a rubbery material. But like I said, the one thing I would say is I just wish it was wider. It's not sticking. Well, here's the deal. Even if this isn't perfect, which it's not, this will be good to have something on here protecting this until we can get real grout put on here. I think I will use the hairdryer on it. I'll get an extension cord and use the hairdryer. Maybe that would help because maybe it just needs to melt a little better. I don't know, honestly. Look. So there's a few little spots, especially in the beveled edges. They're not beveled. I don't know what they are. But look. Sorry. I think that looks pretty darn good. But the little edges I'm definitely concerned with, but that'll at least help keep the water out for now until we can get some actual caulking. We'll see how it holds up in the showers and whatnot. I'll do an update. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Bye. Guys, guess what I almost forgot? The drain. Okay, so this is the TEMU clog undrainer, clogger. Oh. Ours turns at a very sharp angle. Ew. No hair, just something really nasty. And I may not be able to pull anything out of this one because... Okay, that's as far as it's going. Ew, that was a fail. Okay, so the tub was a fail. There's actually not... We have a hair-like thing that we put in the drain that catches hair. Apparently it's working. Ew, disgust. My gosh. Y'all. You guys, that is nasty. All right, that was the first go. Yeah, that time it was dirty. Well, that's a good sign. I don't want to damage the plumbing, so I'm trying to be careful here. Well, that might have been it. All right, guys. That's what we're getting out, I guess. All right, thanks for watching. I think we've tried everything now. All of the items were great from TEMU.